Hi guys, I'm Seth Slash and welcome back to another episode of Road to Power. In today's video, we'll be upgrading the O2M transmission of Gearbox. In our case, we'll be installing a fourth gear support. So, we'll be installing the fourth gear support. In today's video, we'll be briefly describing where to drill, what size to drill on our GQV gearbox. So, with no further ado, let's get drilling. Hi guys. So, over here we have our input shaft, and this is the fourth gear support. As you see, it's tapered or cut in a circular side. This is a brass that you will be applying pressure to the input shaft. So we'll be pressing up against the input shaft. As you see, it has a lip over here. This is going to lie inside the gearbox to clear this gear set. Okay, so the fourth gear support consists of multiple parts. We have a brass, which will be looking like this. As you can see, it's cut half. It will be running on the gear like that. This will be on the inside of your gearbox. This part will be holding the part on the inside of your gearbox. So in between these two will be your gearbox casing. And this is the serviceable part, where you have a seal, you have your brass insert, and as needed, you will be tightening the tension, applying pressure to your fourth gear. So there you have it, guys. This unit presses in. Trying to do this now with one hand. There you can see it. Hope you can see it. So you have to turn it. Turn it a bit. Okay, there we have it. Pressing up against the shaft, our input shaft, and there we're gonna turn in our adjuster. So that's our fourth gear support. One thing I was worried about is this reverse plug. Can probably turn it, but you can measure the distance. I would like to go a bit deeper, but as you can see, you could go a lot deeper with this, because there's a step. There's a step in over there. But yeah, this is where we drilled. So the next step would be to clean the area, glue it, and then we are done. Oh yeah, and remember to put Loctite onto these bolts, and then we are done. So yeah, so that's our second step now. So guys, we're going to use full 300. I normally use Victorines, but this one says it's formulated for gearboxes. So let's see how it works. It is. So I'm gonna add a thin piece around here for the outside. I'm gonna add one around here for the inside. So on the inside we cleaned it, and on the outside we cleaned it. So yeah, let's get cracking. So there you have it, guys. Fourth gear support is installed. Thanks for liking, subscribing, and staying till the end. I hope you enjoyed this video. So up next, we will be installing the steel shift forks. Yeah, and then we will be closing up the gearbox. It's the end of our gearbox modifications. As always, stay tuned to Road to Power for more R32 turbo content. Yeah, as always, like and subscribe, leave a comment down below.